In our second part about interface, we will discuss the screen or canvas and these three tabs: code, costumes, and sound. If the code button is clicked, the lower section shows the program or script for our object. Now the code button is clicked and we see an empty field at the bottom. This means that there is no program for our cat yet. We will do it later. The costumes and sound buttons allow you to customize and change the appearance of our object and the sounds it makes. Okay, let's talk about this section. This white field is a canvas or screen. We create a script for our object and can see how this script works on the canvas. So, if we program the cat to walk, it will move across the canvas. If you hold the left mouse button over the cat and then move the mouse without releasing it, the cat will move. This way we can change its position on the canvas. Move the cat to the different location and look in the object properties section. Note that the X and Y coordinates have changed their values. When some scripts are created for our objects, cat or something else, on the code tab, click the green flag to start our program. To stop our program, click the red circle. Next to the flag and the circle, we see three more buttons. They are designed to change the entire Scratch application window. First one, it's compact view of our screen. Second one is a standard view of our screen. And the third button is full screen control. When we click on this button, we will see full screen of our canvas and can check our program. And that's all about interface of Scratch for now. In the next videos, we will discuss and make our first program.